Static NAT is the most simple form of NAT that you can do. If you watched our video on what is NAT and how it works, then you probably don't have any questions. But there is a little twist to the configuration. Most forms of NAT that are used these days will take advantage of ports and increase the number of devices that you can serve with your available IPs. But with static NAT, that is not the case. It is sometimes called one-to-one NAT, and all it does is take one address and translate it to another. In practice, RouterOS distinguishes between two major types of NAT, source NAT and destination NAT. The idea there is to separate the outgoing connections from incoming connections, because most of the time you do not want strangers on the internet to be able to connect to your LAN devices. Therefore, depending on what you want to accomplish with static NAT, you might have to add one or two NAT rules for the most complete one-to-one conversion. If you have a client device on the LAN and a public IP on your router, then you can add a source NAT rule. When the client is reaching out to the internet, the IP gets translated and any responses coming back also get properly translated. But if somebody tries to initiate a connection to your public IP, they will be connecting to the router and not the client device. So if you have something like a web server on your LAN, then you have a puzzle piece missing and you need to add a destination NAT rule that will translate all the incoming traffic. Here is what these two rules would look like. Go to IP firewall NAT section and type add chain source NAT action source NAT. Source address will be that of your LAN device. Out interface will be your WAN interface, or in this case Ether 8. And of course, the to addresses field will contain your public IP address. That was your source NAT. Next, type add chain destination NAT action destination NAT. The destination address will be your public address, and then the to address will be your LAN address. These are your NAT rules for complete static NAT. Finishing up, a couple of friendly reminders about that destination NAT rule. Make sure you don't have any unnecessarily open ports on your server, as they will all get exposed. And second, if you were previously managing your router using the public IP, then you will no longer be able to do so unless you set up some sort of exception for a port that should not be translated. See you next time.